हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, डियर स्टूडेंट्स. इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस विच इज ट्राइंगल. एंड इन दैट क्लास वी टेक एंड सॉल्व सम इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू एंड योर अपकमिंग एग्जामिनेशन. नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी टेक एंड सॉल्व some other important question of your NCERT exam, which is very important question. So please, dear friends, let's see that question and we simplify that. We solving that question. And the question is, ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle. Okay, dear friends, ABC is a triangle. The bisector of the exterior angle at B, and the bisector of angle C, and the bisector of what? Angle C, okay. Intersect each other at D. Prove that angle D is equal to half of angle A. Angle D is equal to half of angle A. Dear friend, this is one of the most important question of your syllabus triangle. So let's see what is the process to solve that type of question. Okay. So first of all, dear friend, let's see its solution. First of all, dear friend, we draw a triangle ABC. Let's see. First of all, we draw a triangle ABC. And according to question, the bisector of the exterior angle at B. So let us take its side BC produced to P. Suppose that. Let us consider its side BC. Then what is the exterior angle at B? So let's see, the bisector of exterior angle at B is what? This one, let's see. This is the bisector of the exterior angle at B and the bisector of angle C intersect each other at D, na? And the bisector of angle C, which is this, that bisector intersect each other at point D. This is your question here. And let us take that angle is what? We take angle 2, and dear students, that angle we take as angle 1. So this is the question here. Okay, according to question, first of all, we draw ABC is a triangle. We draw what? ABC is a triangle. Okay. Now, according to question, dear students, the bisector of exterior angle at B. So, first of all, for the bisector of exterior angle at B, we just produce its side CB to D and we draw in this way. And the bisector of angle C intersect each other at point D, and we have to show that angle D is equal to half of angle A. Now let's see its solution. So first of all, using exterior angle property in triangle ABC, let's see. In triangle A, B, C, we get, let's see what we get. Dear student, for triangle ABC, this is the exterior angle ABP, and that exterior angle is equal to the sum of its two opposite interior angle. Okay, now so exterior angle ABP, okay, ABP is equal to angle A plus angle C, angle A plus angle C. Now on dividing by two both sides, let's see, or we can write why that 1 upon 2 of exterior angle ABP is equal to half of angle A plus half of angle C. From figure it is clear that, let's see, this is angle 2, this is a bisector, so this is also angle 2. Because of BD is a bisector of exterior angle at B, na? So this is angle 2, so this is also angle 2. So half of angle ABP is right as what? Angle 2 only, na? So that angle is right as angle 2 according to figure, is equal to, we write as angle A by 2 as it is, plus angle C by 2 is what? Let's see. This is also the bisector of angle C. So half of angle C is what? Angle 1. According to that figure, half of angle C is what? Angle 1, na? Because of this is CD is the bisector of angle C. So dear students, in this way, half of angle C is equal to what? Angle 1. So dear students, here we can write as angle 1. Okay. So we take equation first. We take equation 1. So this is a very important question. So let's see once more time here, dear friends. Here, what I do? Let's see. First of all, we draw the figure according to our question. After that, we just produce its side BC to P. And because of, in that question, the bisector of the exterior angle at B. So bisector of exterior angle at B produce to D. Produce, and the internal bisector of angle C intersect each other at D, na? So for that reason, its sides CB produce to P, and after that it is clear that now what I do, dear students, let's see. Now we take the exterior angle property in triangle ABC, and you know that in previous classes we already discussed about that, ki the exterior angle is always equal to the sum of its two opposite interior angle. So for that concept, dear students, here the exterior angle ABP, this is the exterior angle in the respect of triangle ABC. So ABP, exterior angle APB is equal to sum of its two opposite interior angle, like angle A plus angle C. Okay, dear students, now we dividing both sides by 2. Now we divided both sides by 2, so we get this. And you know that here in the given figure it is clear that this is the bisector. So half of angle ABP is equal to angle 2. We can write similarly angle A right as it is, angle A by 2 is left here, and angle C by 2 is right as angle 1, because of this is also the bisector of angle 1, angle C. Okay, so it is clear, dear friends. So in this way we form that equation first. Now similarly in triangle BCD, similarly in triangle BCD, similarly in triangle BCD, we apply the exterior angle property we get. Similarly in triangle BCD we apply the exterior angle property. Then let's see, in respect of angle BCD, respect of triangle BCD, so this is your exterior angle 2. Okay, so exterior angle what? 2 is equal to sum of its two opposite interior angle, means angle D plus angle D angle D plus angle C, I mean that angle 1. That angle 1. Okay, angle 2 is equal to angle D plus angle 1. Take equation number 2. Now what I do? Now using equation 1 and 2. Now dear friends, now using equation 1 and 2, we get this is angle 2 and this is also angle 2, so we both are equal to each other. So we have, now let me, thus from equation 1 and 2 we get this is angle 2, this is also angle 2, so we have angle D plus angle 1 is equal to angle A by 2 plus angle first, angle A by 2 plus angle first. Okay, now let's see here, angle 1 is cancelled to each other, so we get angle D is equal to 1 by 2 of angle A, means vertical angle. Hence proof. Hence proof. Okay, dear friends. So this is one of the most important question of your syllabus. So please, dear friend, do more and more practices of that type of question. After that, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. So please, first revise and do more and more practices of that type of question. Let's see once more time, because of this is very consensual questions, okay, of your syllabus. So let's see once more time, we take roughly, we solving that question once more time in front of you. First of all, this one, according to question, what is the question here? Here the bisector of exterior angle at B and the internal bisector of angle C intersect each other at point D. We have to show that that angle is equal to the half of its vertical angle A. Okay, this is the question here. So first of all, we draw that figure and we take that is angle 2 and that is angle 1. Now first of all, we apply the exterior angle property in triangle ABC. So if we apply exterior angle property, then you know that this is the exterior angle ABC. Exterior angle ABC is equal to sum of its two opposite interior angle 1 plus angle C. Now what I do after that, we dividing both side by 2. So we dividing both side by 2. So we get what? We get half of angle ABC is what? Angle 2 here is equal to half of angle A right as it is, and half of angle C is angle 1. We take equation 1. Now again we apply the exterior angle property in triangle BCD. BCD. So for so this is exterior angle in respect to the triangle BCD. So angle 2 is equal to what? Angle D plus angle 1. Angle D plus angle 1. We take equation 2. Okay. Now using equation 1 and 2, we equate the value of angle 2. So here we write angle A by 2 plus 1 is equal to angle D plus angle 1. Angle 1 cancel to each other. So angle D is equal to half of angle A by 2. Hence proof. Okay. So in this way, this is the process to solve that type of question. So please dear students, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that, you can solve each and every question in of your syllabus based on this topic. This is very important result also. So please, that result remember in your mind always. Based on that topic, that result, that there are so many questions is come in some competitive examination. So it is remember also in your mind, dear friends, ki the external bisector at B, exterior angle bisector at B, and the internal bisector of base, any other base angle, intersect each other at any point, that angle is always equal to the half of the vertical angle. Similarly, we also discuss so many important results based on this topic. So please learn each and every result related to that topic. Okay, dear friends, so which is very important for you and your upcoming examination. Now we take and solve some other important question of your syllabus. Let's see. Now, listen, we take and solve some other important question related to that chapter. And your question is, let's see the question. In the given figure, AM perpendicular to BC and AN is the bisector of angle A is the bisector of angle A. If angle B is equal to 65 degree, and angle C is equal to 33 degree. Find angle MAN. Now let's see its solution. Okay. Dear student, this is a very important question. Now let's see the figure, and your figure is here. ABC is a triangle in which AM perpendicular to BC. AM perpendicular to BC and AN is the bisector of angle A. AN is the bisector of angle A. Okay. And angle B is equal to what? 65 degree. And angle C is equal to what? 33 degree. Now we find angle M. Okay. Dear students, in previous classes, we have to show a very important result related to that one. Here, dear students, AM is perpendicular to BC from its opposite vertex A, and AN is the bisector of angle A. Okay, then we find the angle between perpendicular and that bisector, that is angle MAN. Now first of all, we write given angle B is equal to 65 degree, angle A is equal to 60 degree, AM is perpendicular to BC. Okay, and angle BAN is equal to angle NAC. Because of AN is the bisector of angle A. AN is the bisector of angle A. And related to that topic, we have a very important result. So since we know that, angle MAN is equal to half of angle B minus angle C. This is a very important result. We have to show it in previous classes. Okay. So now from there, the angle MAN is equal to, we put the value of angle B is what? 65, and at angle C is what? 33. So we get angle 2, 1 by 2 into 5 minus 3, that is 2. 5 minus 3, that is 2 now. And 6 minus 3, that is 3. Now let's see. 16. So, dear students, in this way, the value of angle MAN is equal to 16 degree. This is the required solution of the given question. Okay, so dear friends, please do more and more practices of that type of result, and based on that result you can solve so many questions of your NCERT exam based on this topic. Now we take and solve some other important questions related to that chapter. Let's see.
एक क्वेश्चन, इन द गिवन फिगर फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स, योर क्वेश्चन इज इन द गिवन फिगर फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स, ओके, इन द गिवन फिगर फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स, लेट्स सी फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज वन, A, B, C, D, that is 120 and this is X, this is 112, okay. Now, second part of this question, dear friends, the second part is what, let's see, this is the figure here, this is A, B, C, A, B, C, D, E, okay, and this is 120, this is X, this is 110, okay, and third part of this question, dear friends, third part of this question is what? A, B, C, D, E, and this is 40 degree, this is X, and this is 52. Now, this is the question here. So, these are the very important questions related to your syllabus. So, please, dear student, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise. Let's see, dear friends. So first of all, let us take and solve first part of this question, okay? And the first part is what? Let's see here. In triangle ABC, first of all, let's see here. CA is the straight line. So first of all, we find that angle, and this is the linear pair. So angle A is equal to 180 minus 120, that is as this 60. So this is what? 60 degree. Now, so in this way we get the angle A is what? 60 degree. Now we apply, thus we apply the exterior angle property, exterior angles in triangle ABC. Now we apply the exterior angle property in triangle ABC. We get, let's see, this is the exterior angle ACD. So exterior angle ACD is equal to sum of its two opposite interior angle, means angle A plus angle B. Okay, now exterior angle ACD is equal to 112, so here we put 112, A is equal to, angle A is what, 60 degree, angle B is what, X, which we find here, okay. Now, from there, the value of X is 112 minus 60, so we get 112, 60, subtracting them to, this is 552. This is the required solution of the given question, okay. So this is the process to solve that type of question. So please just do more and more practices of that type of question. Similarly, we take and solve the next part of this question. Let's see. Now, we take and solve the second part of this question, which is what? Let's see. In triangle ABC, here BC, EBCD is a straight line, and so they form a linear pair, na? Now, from figure, it is clear that angle B is equal to 180 minus 120, that is what? 60 degrees. So this is what? 60 degrees. And angle C is equal to 180 minus 110, that is what? 70 degrees. This is what? 70 degrees. Okay, so angle C, interior angle C is what? 70 degrees. Now,
for finding the value of X, here we apply the angle sum property of the triangle. Now,
we apply the angle sum property of the triangle, that is angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180. Angle A is what? X. Angle B is what? Plus angle C is what? 70 is equal to 180. Now from there we get what? X plus 130 is equal to 180. So from there value of X is 180 minus 130, that is X is equal to 180 minus 30 is what? 50 degree. Okay, so this is what? 50 degree. This is the required solution of the given question. Okay,
so using that concept you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on the topic triangle and its property. Okay, now we take and solve the next part of this question. Let's see.
Now let's see the diagram once more time. This is your figure. This is A, B, C, D, E. This is 52 degree. This is X. This is 40 degree. Okay. Now, let's see what I do. Dear students, here, this is the figure. We find the value of X. Now, let's see here. Here, let's see here, AB parallel to CD. From figure, AB parallel to CD and DA as a transversal. DA as a transversal and DA as a transversal. That is, angle D is equal to angle BAD, that is angle D is equal to 52 degree.
Angle D is equal to 52 degree. Now
in triangle DCE, X plus 52, we apply the angle sum property, so we get X plus to 180. This is X is equal to 180 minus 92, 88. This is 88 degree. So this, in this way, the value of X in this for that figure is 88.
So in this way you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on that topic.
Okay, dear students. So these are very important question. So please dear students, do more and more practices of that type of questions.
Okay, so now in next class we take and solve some other important concept related to that chapter, triangle, mean congruency of triangles. Okay, now thanks to all.